make a 30-second advertisement about your community. We want you to show us the best things about your community, the lakes, the waterholes, the fishing, the schools, the alpha shops, whatever it is that you love. Upload it, tag us, and the best one will win this ball.
My name is Chantel. I'm a TA here at Marrara. My favorite thing to do in this community is work with all of the staff because they have become great friends and hang out with you guys. In my community, there is lots of buildings, there's teachers, there's classrooms, there's even family group homes where you guys get to stay. The jobs people do in this community are teaching. We have librarians, we have garden maintenance people, we even have TAs. I think people should come visit my community because we have so much fun together, and I think the people are what make it different and make it good, and we have the best people in the whole world here.
Hello everybody, this is Mr. Tony, and you're back home because of the COVID-19. Well, my community starts here at Marrara, and we're going to look at quite a number of different kinds of things. Why don't you come with me and I'll show you. One of the things that we've got in our communities, well, back home where you are, and even here at Marrara, are natural and built things. Natural things are like the trees and the bush, although this is a garden, so this would be built. But out back in the bushland, that would be natural because nobody is building it or watering it. Part of our community are all the kids here at school, and they do sport, academic activities, all sorts of things, and they're part of our community. You're there with your community, and that includes family. I'm going to show you some of my family. Some of the work that you've got to do is all about kinship. And this is the lady that I'm really fond of. This is Mrs. Dieb, actually. It's a little bit noisy here because this is the power station area. We use power and water for our services, for our electricity and our water. But these are solar systems that in our community here at school, it's generated by the solar panels on the roof. And when we use a little bit more than the solar panels can make, then we draw power off the grid. Just before I show you the built thing, I want to show you a couple of things that have been printed here in the tented courtyard. Hold on, what's this? Take a look at an awesome thing that's been built while you've been away. And I reckon you mob are gonna love it. Folks, on the other side of the fence is a completely natural feature. People didn't have anything to do with that. That's all grown by itself. The trees, the grass, there's animals in there on the other side of the fence. Now this is Claudia, this is my daughter, and she works here in the science labs. And what do you do here?
I stop things from exploding. I look after chemicals and scientific equipment. I make sure that if there's a bottle with a label in it, what's in that matches the label and that everything works. So that the science is possible when the teachers are teaching classes.
All right, thank you. We're going to say goodbye, Claudie, but we've got to do it COVID-19 way. And there we go. Kids, enjoy your house. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Hey, Marrara Arty friends. What we're going to do today is we're looking at Andy Goldsworthy. I'm going to show you some stuff of his. And then we're going to create our own organic piece of artwork. Looking forward to seeing what you guys come up with. We miss you at school. We miss you. All right, we'll see you soon.
So our work that we're going to be doing today is inspired by Andy Goldsworthy. So let's have a little look at his work. Isn't that amazing? He uses all natural materials, so all organic things he finds, and he arranges them, usually to do with colours, but also shapes and patterns. Look at those ferns. Oh. When you lost hope, soon you will be found.
I'm going to go outside now, and I'm going to have a hunt for some cool leaves or sticks or rocks that I could potentially make into a piece of artwork, just like Annie Goldsworthy. All right, let's check it out.
All right, so just come back from being outside, which was lovely. And I picked a few leaves and some nuts I found, and these beautiful hibiscus, and some pebbles, and a stick, which I broke into smaller pieces. All right, let's have fun. I'm gonna create something, so I'm gonna have a little play with what I've got here. So you can see here, I've started to arrange my collection into a pattern. But how cool is it looking? Now you could leave this if you wanted to. You could definitely do this and leave it outside, like on the grass or on the pavement for someone to see. If you do one, please take a photo and send it to us. We'd love to see what natural artworks you come up with.
Hey guys, this is Mrs. Spider, and I'm here to help you guys get active and fit and strong and get off your couch and move your bodies and have some fun doing it. So I hope you really enjoy it. I'm just gonna give you some exercises and you just follow along. Okay, our first exercise is walking on the spot, and just to get ourselves warm. So what I want you to do is pretend you're a soldier and lifting your knees up high and marching on the spot. Next exercise is called a windmill. So I want you to be like a star and your legs are a width apart, and you're going to be touching your toes like a windmill. Okay, now for a lateral stretch. So we're gonna stretch the side of our body out and lift your arm up right over your head and feel that stretch right up through your body. The next one is a wall sit. And this is seriously my most not favorite one, but I hope you guys can do it. So you are going to sit 90 degrees. I think I'm 90 degrees. And you just have to sit against the wall and don't move. Okay, the next one is a wall push-up. So just like you would do a push-up on the ground, you're gonna do it against the wall. So all you need is a nice, straight, strong wall. And have your hands same height as your shoulders. Next one is a plank. So you should all know how to do the plank. I'm gonna do this for 1 minute, and I want you to keep nice and strong and still and body straight. So elbows on the ground, like this, and up on your toes. Okay, that's it from Mrs. Plater, and I hope you guys aren't missing us too much. And you can do those exercises, you can repeat them two or three times, however you feel, or however many times you want. Have fun, guys.
I'm Miss Kay, and I'm going to do a maths lesson on time. In the Aboriginal culture, time has been measured by stories. It's considered that it's been measured in a cyclic way, that things come around and go around like that. Oral, memory stories. But in the Western culture, we've measured time by putting it on a straight line. We call that linear. we consider that there's a beginning and an end. And the clock is a big example. When is the sunset today? Google, Mr. Google told me it was 6:28 p.m. So the p.m. bit means it's in the afternoon. 6:28 means 6 hours, 28 minutes. I want to work out how much time it is between now and sunset. So as I turn this blue hand, which is minutes, all the way around once, my hour hand has gone 1 hour. So it's 1 hour. 2 hours. 3 hours, and that is 6:10. Sunset was at 6:28. 5, 10. There is 6:28. So it was 3 hours and 18 minutes. I think I got that right. And that is our lesson on time.
Hi guys. So today we're going to talk about anger. Anger is not necessarily a really bad emotion, but the way that you act or behave makes it sometimes really bad. But let's look at an example that will explain the cycle of anger.
It's the show. Look, she's got a pimple on her chin. I'm going to share this on Facebook. That will be funny.
Oh, Facebook notification. Louise, she's shared my picture on Facebook. Look at my huge pimple. How could she do that? She's supposed to be my best friend.
Don't even come near me.
What now?
So we can compare anger to a volcano. So imagine that the volcano is the event. So the same thing that happened when Louise shared my photo on social media. The next thing that's going to happen is the negative thoughts. So the negative thoughts was that I wanted to bash Louise up because she shared that. I didn't even think about any positive thoughts. Then the next one is your emotional response. That's the way that you feel. So I really felt hurt and frustrated that Louise sent the photo on social media. Then was the physical symptoms. That's the way that my body felt. I could feel my heart beating faster. I could hear my breathing and I was ready to fight her. So that's all my physical symptoms. All building up. So with all of these things build up, then the next thing that's going to happen is all of it is just going to overflow. So you are able to break that cycle where it overflows. So when you're in a situation where you're really angry, the first thing that you need to do is calm yourself. You can do that easily with taking a few deep breaths. You can always use your hand. Just go breathe in, breathe out. The next thing that you need to do is to be aware of your thoughts. If you have any negative thoughts, try to change it to more positive thoughts. In my case, I could have thought not to bash Louise, but rather thinking, oh, maybe she didn't realize that it would really hurt me when she shared that photo about me. The next one that you need to do is to become aware of your feelings. How do you feel? And also, how do you feel inside your body? When I sat there and I saw that photo, I could really feel my heart beating faster. I was really working myself up. I was ready to bash out. I could feel it in the tension in my body. So becoming aware of that, I can say and make a choice to change that. You can easily do that by using your senses. You can look for 5 things that you can see. What can you feel? Can you feel the wind blowing on your arm or your feet on the ground? And name 3 things that you can hear. Then 2 things that you can smell and then lastly, one thing that you can taste. By doing that, you will bring yourself back to the present and you will it will help yourself just to think about the situation. Bye!
Hi everybody, my name is Teresa McKee and I'm a science teacher here at Marrara Christian College. I hope you're all safe and today I was just going to do a little lesson on which my friend Susan here is going to help me with. Normally we would have ribs in front of this section here, and the ribs are really important because they protect two of the most important organs in our body, and that is the lungs and the heart. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the lungs and the heart today, and year 8s and year 7s, you will have got a booklet or be getting a booklet which is all about the human body, and in particular you've got bits about the lungs, which are part of the respiratory system, and the heart, which is part of the circulatory system. And the heart beats, as we said, and you can feel how fast your heart is beating. You could put your head up against someone's chest and you'd be able to hear their heart beating. But you can take your pulse rate, and year 8 and year 7, on page 22 of your booklet, you've got a practical activity where you're being asked to see how exercise affects your heart rate. The way you can do that to take your heart rate is just to use two fingers on your wrist. At the wrist, the arteries come close enough for you to be able to feel the pulse in here, or you could do it here on your neck, either side. So year 7, 8, you've been asked to take what that is when you're sitting quietly, and then to do a walk and to do a run and to see what happens to your heart rate. One of the things that I know some of the students here have is rheumatic heart disease. What happens sometimes is when we get an infection, so often, most often starting as a sore throat, the bacteria that cause that infection can move down into the heart and can damage these here. So these are the valves that separate the heart. And if these get damaged, that means the heart can't work properly. Some students get minor damage to these with rheumatic heart disease, and then the doctor says you need to have a needle every month to prevent you from getting another infection so that these don't get damaged. It's really important that if that is you, that you do actually get that needle right on time every month and don't be late. Having to be a little bit more isolated, take the time to go for a walk, go for a run. It's not just good for you, it's also good for your heart.
Alright, hi everybody. I hope that you're all well. I'm missing all my beautiful students and I hope that you're keeping safe and healthy. So today I wanted to show you how to make a quick and simple fried rice. I thought it would be something that you all have the ingredients for at home. And it's definitely something that you can use different ingredients and mix things up. So I will teach you how to do that today. So first off, we're washing our hands and remember we sing happy birthday through twice. Alright, so I have cooked my rice in a rice bucket today, but the best rice for fried rice is leftover rice from the day before when it's dried out a bit. So if you've got leftover rice, this is a great recipe to use that up. And then over here I've got some frozen peas and corn. I've got some bacon diced up here. I've grated some carrot and, can't tip that one up. I've got some eggs for the omelette part. So I'm going to give them a quick mix. So I'll heat that up with a bit of oil, whatever oil you've got. Today I'm using peanut, but you can use olive or vegetable oil. So I'm going to cook my bacon first. That's raw, so that needs to be cooked well. If you use ham, you can add it in at the same time as your veggies. So the other ingredient that we've got is soya sauce. Alright, you don't want to use too much of that because it is very salty, but that is one of the main ingredients for your fried rice. Alright, our bacon is cooked, so I am going to put the vegetables in now. It's gone. And then we are going to add our rice. Right, we'll mix this together more in a moment, but we're actually going to do our omelette now. So you don't need to get out another pan, nobody likes dishes, so I always do it in the same. Just push your fried rice to the side, add a little bit more oil, it up for a second. And then you pour your egg straight in to make your omelette. So that was 4 eggs. I like a lot of egg in my fried rice, lots of omelette, so you can do less eggs if you like, use whatever you've got. So it's pretty much cooked through, just use your spatula or your wooden spoon, cut it up into some pieces. And then it's time to mix it all through.